Okay, here we are for another installment with trying to capture some a wild beehive. This is Larry again, along with
Dick
and
Craig.
All right, and what we have here is an old house that has a double brick wall, and whenever the fellow who's tearing it down tore into this part, he found a bunch of bees. So we're going to check it out and see what we can come up with. Well, here is what we found. A lot of buzzing. And a hole up here they're working around. Something.
Oh, here's some capped. I didn't see that. Maybe on the back side.
Well, Dick suggested we get a few shots here. And I will try not to get stung because they are quite buzzing around. We've torn out some more of the brick. We cut away a lot of the comb. You can see where we have it over here, and it's a lot of just dried, unused comb. But our hunch is that there's a lot of activity going in and out among the bricks here, and that they are probably behind the wall right over here. So that's our latest update. They're buzzing all around, and Dick is running two smokers. Yeah. Look at that guy.
What a guy.
And here is our homeowner. And what's your name? Paul
Winkleblack.
Winkleblack. Yep. All right. How'd the honey taste?
Oh, that's about the best. I mean, better than out of a jar.
You bet.
Dude.
Okay, we've been cutting away a lot of comb. There's a lot of comb over here that is just dried out, not being used. But this is all honey, and we noticed as we were cutting away, we had this brick, kind of diagonal, sitting there. Don't know why. Don't know what the purpose would be, but it's nice and diagonal. Been there since the house was built around the time of the Civil War. And the bees have been here for about 30 years. So we've got a long, big hive, and it'll be interesting to see where they have ventured off to. All right, well, we had fun knocking down some more wall, but we're kind of afraid the rest is gonna come down on us. So we still haven't found the what I think is probably the main brood chamber. It's probably somewhere in this area, but Dick keeps saying, Larry, don't hit it anymore. Yeah. I swear the wall is starting to move. What harm could a brick wall do? You know, but anyway, what we're gonna do is we've got some brood and we've got honey for them, and what we're gonna do is try to suck up a whole bunch of bees. And if we have a queen, we got a queen. If we don't, then just buy one to introduce to it. Because my hunch is she's somewhere in here, hidden. And again, I don't mind hitting the wall some more, but I really don't want the doctor bill, hospital bill. I don't want to have to be flown to Carl. So next time we check in, we'll see what else we have. Figure we tore up enough of this guy's house that we're gonna wrap up. Sucked up as much bees as we can, but have no idea whether a queen was in it.
Yeah.
But we picked up quite a bit of honey. And what are your thoughts on this particular bee removal?
This was a lot easier than the other one. That's for dang sure.
Digging underneath the shed.
Yes.
And we look a little cleaner.
Yes, we do.
Especially you after the...
That was pretty messy.
All right. But, well, we appreciate the opportunity. And you'll be tearing down the house when?
Oh, as soon as possible.
As soon as possible. Yeah. You got some stuff in there you may want to remove.
Yeah, there's a few odds and ends in there we got to get out yet.
All right. Well... Thank you much, and next time we see you, we'll either have a little bit of this installation or our next time venturing out trying to remove bees. So this is Larry and
Dick.
We'll see you next time.